Hi folks, CodeTutor here, and my name is Anil Deshpande. In the previous video, we have seen how to trigger a dialog using the mutable state variable. So you updated the value of the is dialog visible to true or false to control whether the dialog is made visible or not. In this video, we will continue to build on top of this. The next obvious question is, how do you pass the data from the dialog to the composable from which it was triggered? Well, we can once again use the concept of callback. So what we will do is, we will maintain another variable val data is equal to mutable state of string. So that will take care of having a data variable which will hold the value. Now what I will do is go to the sample dialog definition and then create another function as a callback, so on data, and that will also be a string unit. So on click of confirmation button, what I can do is on data and pass a string just on click of the confirmation button, and then I will go back to the screen one, and here I will pass on data. Once I receive the data, I will set it to data.val. I think it is not taking. Let me change it as dialog data. Dialog data dot value is equal to. So with this, we basically set the data here. And once again, I can write another when clause is dialog visible and dialog data dot value dot is not empty. In that case, I will make a toast. Toast dot make text nav controller dot context, that will give me the text. Then here I will take the dialog data dot value and I will toast it, and then finally toast dot length long dot show. And now let me run this show dialog, and on confirm I should get the text. I think it is negation. Show dialog confirm, the toast message is now visible. The toast message is visible. This is the sample data. That is what, this is exactly what you are seeing in the toast. So now we know how to trigger a dialog box from the screen itself. And we also know how to pass the data from the dialog to the screen in which it was triggered. But this is not the only way to trigger a dialog. You can trigger a dialog as a part of the NavGraph itself. Well, what do I mean by that? If you recall, the way we are controlling the navigation is through this, that is get my NavGraph, and we had created these three composables. Even the dialog box is a composable. So in effect, you can use the NavGraph to trigger the dialog. What we will do is, instead of using composable, we will write dialog, and then just like you used to write a root to a screen, which is a full-fledged window screen, you can write a root to a dialog. I can write sample dialog, and then here I can write sample dialog on dismiss request. What I can do is use nav controller, that is controller dot pop backstack to close the dialog. I can pretty much do the same in case of on confirm, and here I will say nav graph dialog, and here this is a dialog triggered from nav graph, the information and icon, icons dot field dot, instead of info I can use just to differentiate build. So this is a different dialog box. And what I can go back here and do is change the definition, because I don't need on data or a callback mechanism to send the data. So I am going to remove this. This is not needed anymore. And now let me go back to the sample dialog. There is compilation error. Let me remove this. This is not needed anymore. Let me go back to the screen one. This is also not needed. Actually, this whole thing is not needed, because you are not now dependent on the state to make the dialog visible or not. And then you don't need this as well to pass the data. I will tell you why so in a moment. Now, when you click on show dialog button, instead of using the state variable to make a dialog visible or invisible, what you will do is navcontroller.navigateSampleDialog. It is the same mechanism that you used to use to trigger a screen, that is navigate screen 2. In that case, it was a completely different screen. Here in this case, now it is a dialog. So dialog will get triggered. We will see whether it works or not. So let me run this, and you can see that on click of this, now you have a NavGraph dialog. This is a dialog triggered from the NavGraph. And on click of confirm, it will close. How did it close? If you go back here, we are closing it using the controller pop backstack, just like you used to do the controller.pop backstack to go back to the previous screen. In this case, you are going back to the screen by closing the dialog. Okay, the next obvious question would be, how do I pass the data from the dialog to a screen? Well, it's not that complicated. We have already seen when you are working with composable, how do you pass the data from one screen to another screen. We basically spent last couple of weeks exploring that. We can apply the same concept here as well. You basically make it as a part of the nav controller backstack entry arguments. Or if you want to use much more refined method, you can always rely on the shared view model. So that's it about the dialog navigation. In the next video, we will meet with another new topic. That brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video, and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.